Hello everyone, in this video we will discuss about how to find the support reaction for the beam by taking variety of examples. Our first example is the beam shown below is supported by a pin at A and roller at B. Calculate the reactions at both supports due to the loading. So in this question we have to find the reactions at both the supports. So for this we have to identify the support system for the beam. So at point A there is a hinge support, which means that it will be having two reactions, one in the vertical direction, that is RAY, and another one in the horizontal direction, that is RAX. Similarly, at point B there is a roller support, which means that it will be having only one support reaction and in the vertical direction, that is RBY. Now we proceed to the solution of this question. After identifying the support reaction for the beam, our next step is to draw the free body diagram. So at point A, there are two support reactions, RAY and RAX, and at point B, there is only one support reaction, that is RBY, and we have to calculate these three values. 20 kN point load is acting at 2 meter distance from point A, and 40 kN point load is acting at 5 meter distance from point A. Now we will be applying the equations of static equilibrium, that is, first equation is summation of moment at point B is equal to 0. So in this, clockwise moment about the point B will be positive and anticlockwise moment about the point B will be negative. So at point A, the vertical force RAY at a distance of 9 meter from point B will generate a clockwise moment. So RAY into 9 minus 20 into 7 and then minus 40 into 4 equal to 0. So it will give us the value of RAY. So RAY will be 33.3 kN. Now applying our second equation of static equilibrium, that is summation of Fy is equal to 0. So in this we use the sign convention of vertical upward positive and vertical downward forces are negative. So RAY and RBY are vertically upward, so they are positive, and 20 kN and 40 kN forces are negative. So RAY plus RBY minus 20 minus 40 is equal to 0. RAY we have found out. So RBY will be 26.7 kN. Now we will use our third equation of static equilibrium, that is summation of forces in horizontal direction is equal to 0. So there is only one force, one support reaction, that is RAX. So RAX is equal to 0. So in this way we have found out the three support reactions value. Now we proceed to our second question. Now in this question, determine the reactions at support A and support B for overhanging beam subjected to the loading as shown. So in this we have a uniformly distributed load of 15 kN per meter. So it is distributed along the 3 meter length. So 15 into 3, it will give us 45 kN value. And then a 20 kN load is acting at the overhang of the ends. Now one support is pinned support, so it will be having two support, and another is roller support, so it will be having one support reaction. Now we will proceed to its solution. After the identification of the support system for the beam, our next step is to draw the free body diagram. So now at point A there are two support reactions, that is RAY and RAX. And at point B, there is one support reaction, that is RBY. So we have to calculate the values of these three. Now we will apply the equations of static equilibrium to determine their value. So by taking the moment at A, now we are taking the moment at point A. Now clockwise will be positive and anticlockwise will be negative. So if we see RBY, so it is generating a anticlockwise moment along the point A with a distance of 7 meter. So minus RBY into 7 plus 20 into 9, that is 4 plus 3 plus 2 into 20, and then plus UDL. So UDL moment will be 15 into 3 will be the force, and it will act at the centroid center of the 3 meter, that is 1.5 meter. And from point A, the distance will be 4 plus 1.5, that is 5.5 meter. So we get 15 into 3 into 5.5. So from this, we can get the value of RBY. RBY is coming out to be 61.07 kN. After finding the value of RBY, we will apply our second static equilibrium equation, that is summation of Fy is equal to 0. So in vertically upward is positive and vertically downward is negative. So RAY plus RBY minus 20 minus 15 into 3 will be minus 45. So from there we can get the value of RAY, that is 3.93 kN. Now applying the third equation, that is summation of Fx is equal to 0. So now there is only one support reaction in the horizontal direction, no other forces in horizontal direction, so RAx is equal to 0. So now in this way we have found out the value of RBY, RAy and RAx. Now we will proceed to the third question. In example 3, a cantilever beam is loaded as shown. Determine all reactions at support A. Now at support A, support A is the fixed support, so it will be having three support reactions, that are RAy, RAx and a moment MA. Then we are applying a UVL, that is uniformly varying load. So now to calculate the cumulative load, we will find the area of the triangle, that will be half into base into height, so half into 5 into 2. It will be the cumulative load and it will act at centroid of the triangle. So from base it will be at 1/3 distance. Now a 20 kN force is acting inclined, so it will be resolving into the two components. One will be the horizontal component and one will be the vertical component. So its horizontal component will be 20 into 4/5 and its vertical component will be 20 into 3/5. And then our moment is acting of 15 kN meter. So now let's proceed to its solution. Now first step is to draw the free body diagram. So at point A there are three support reactions, and that are RAy, RAx and MA. Now we will use the equation of static equilibrium to solve this question. So first step is summation of Fx is equal to 0. So in earlier cases there is only one support reaction and no other forces are acting in horizontal direction. So RAx is coming out to be 0. But in this case RAx have some value. So RAx plus the horizontal component of inclined load, that is 20 into 4/5, and it will be equal to 0. So RAx is equal to minus 16 kN. Minus signifies that the direction will be opposite. Now our second step is summation of Fy is equal to 0. So in this, vertically upward will be positive and vertically downward will be negative. So RAy minus cumulative load will be half into 5 into 2 and then vertical component of 20 kN, that is 20 into 3/5. So we can solve this equation and find out the value of RAy. RAy is coming out to be 17 kN. Now we can apply our third equation of static equilibrium, that is summation of MA is equal to 0. So in this, anticlockwise moment will be negative and clockwise moment will be positive. So we can see that minus MA and then plus cumulative load into the centroidal distance for the UVL. So cumulative load is half into 5 into 2 and then centroidal distance is 1/3 from the base of the triangle, that is 1/3 into 2 meter. So in this way we can find the moment of the UVL, and then for the inclined it will be vertical component and the distance is 4 meter. So 20 into 3/5 into 4 and then a 15 clockwise moment. So we can solve this for MA, MA is coming out to be 66.3 kilonewton meter. So we have to find these three reactions, that are RAX, RAY and MA, and we have find out. So in this way we have done this question. So hope you enjoyed this session, and if you like this session, then please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.